Everyone, this is Miss Erica. How are you today? I am excited to share our topic for today, which is David chooses God's way. Let's begin with prayer. Father God, we just thank you for every single child that's hearing your word, Lord God. Lord God, that they, like David, will choose your way. Thank you for your glory and your anointing upon them, Lord God. Thank you for everything that you're doing in their lives, Lord God. As they hear your word, Lord God, we pray for favor, Lord God, that they'll grow in your word and understanding and revelation, Lord God. And thank you, Father, for giving me the words that will inspire and encourage them to live a God that's pleasing, live a way that's pleasing in your sight. So I thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's get started. So our scripture verse is Psalms 124, verse 8. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. So do you know? Got some questions for you today. Here is the first question. Who watched over the sheep and protected them? Now, if you were listening to either the videos, or if you came to our Sunday service for Children's Church and Kingdom Fun, you should know this answer. Who watched over the sheep and protected them? David. That is right. Now, who was the Philistine giant that David went up against? Do you remember? Goliath, Goliath, Goliath. Now, you definitely should know this one. Who helped David be brave? Of course, it was God. So in our next part of the story, we're going to talk about respect. Respect is how you treat someone or something in a proper way. Now, we know David was a man after God's own heart, and that happened through his character, how he showed obedience to God, how he listened to God, and how he showed respect to the people in authority. Well, you remember Saul, right? King Saul, and how did he feel about David? He didn't like David. Why? Because he was jealous of David. Does God want us to be jealous? No, he doesn't want us to compare our lives with somebody else. We know that God has called us for a plan and a purpose, and we have to walk that out. And our walk is not like anybody else's walk. Well, King Saul led 3,000 soldiers to find David. He was on a mission. He wanted to find David and capture him and even kill him. Well, David had sent out his scouts to find out where King Saul and his soldiers were stationed. And when the scouts came back, they reported to David and Absalom, and they crept up to the camp. And they found David and all the men sound asleep. It was dark. It was quiet. They crept in and they saw Saul with his spear and a jug. Now, Abishai, he thought, this was an opportunity to get rid of King Saul. But David said, no, don't do it. Don't do it. But Abishai was like, God has given you a chance to kill him. Why not? And David said, no, we won't do it. He was chosen by God. He is king and wouldn't be right to kill him. Even after all that David went through, even though knowing that King Saul was trying to kill David and harm him, David was not going to do the same thing back. So, when David and Abishai got some distance away, David called out to Abner, that was King Saul's commander, and he said, Abner said, who is calling me? And David said, it is I. Why didn't you guard your king? I took the king's spear and water jug. Now King Saul heard David's voice, and he said, David, is that your voice, my son? And David answered, yes, it is, my king. Why are you chasing me? What have I done wrong? Saul replied, I have sinned. Come back. You could have killed me, but you didn't. I won't try to kill you again. David told Saul to send someone after the king's spear and water jug because he wanted to give it back. I did the right thing today, David said. I could have killed you, but I didn't because God chose you to be king. Now, may God help me whenever I get into trouble. Then Saul said, may you be blessed. You will do great things. Then David went away, and Saul and his men returned home. So, when might it be hard to treat someone with respect? It might be hard if they tried to hurt you, right? Or called you names, right? Oh, that would be hard if somebody punched you or tripped you, or even as you were standing in line to go somewhere, they kind of jumped in front of line and you're like, wait a minute, I was there first. And like, no, I was there. It might kind of be hard to treat them with respect, but God still wants us to do that. He wants us to choose to do what is right, even when it's hard. And I know you can. I know you can do what's right, even when it's hard. Even when you don't feel like it, you can choose to do what's right. And the thing about it is, David had help. Who was David's help? God. And God is your help. When it's really hard, God is going to be there to help you. He's going to give you the courage to stand strong and show respect. And God will send people around you to help you. Just like David has somebody, God will send somebody to help you. It could be your parents, could be a brother or sister or a cousin or a friend. God will send somebody to help you in your times of trouble. And when you do the right thing, guess what? Right things get done back to you. When you show respect to others, they will end up showing respect to you. Let's pray. Father God, we just thank you for this time and opportunity to share your word. I pray, Lord God, that you will help them in so many ways to show respect to others, even when it's hard. Just as you help David, you can help us to treat other people the right way, with kindness, with love, and respect. So we thank you for all these things. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, again, I so enjoyed sharing the word of God with you and sharing about David. God bless you, and I will see you next time. Goodbye, everyone.